You won't believe what disgusting illegal aliens are demanding U.S. taxpayers give them now. It seems like the logical thing for those who are breaking the law to try and hide their transgressions, in order to avoid punishment. Unfortunately, the United States has, under the leadership of Obama, adopted such lenient, and even rewarding policies for illegal immigrants, that they've been apt to put their status out in the open in the hopes of getting a pat on the back. Not only are the illegals living outside of our laws here in the U.S., they're using their status to get everything from free food to free education, and getting more demanding by the day. In what is possibly the most ridiculous of the unending barrage of ridiculous ultimatums from illegals, the out-in-the-open, loud and proud illegals that attend Columbia University have released a list of demands pointed toward the university, asking that they give them lots of free stuff and protect them from the government, among other things. Lest you think I'm exaggerating, here's a little rundown of what they're asking the Ivy Leagues for. Via the Blaze. A group of undocumented immigrants at Columbia University in New York City is demanding concessions from their Ivy League school. The group, known as the Undocumented Students Initiative or UNDUCU, released a list of 13 demands last week that include things like increased protection from federal authorities who might want to deport them, subsidized summer housing, full reimbursement of health care fees, specialized fundraising, counseling and sensitivity training for all Columbia faculty, along with other demands. "We refuse to amend or change any of these demands," the group wrote in a Facebook post last week. We expect the university to act. To begin, the group demands clarification in the university's policies toward its undocumented students, should they have their deferred action for childhood arrivals or DACA status revoked. How will the university help us cope with our legal working rights being taken away? How will the university help with our inability to pay tuition or housing? The group wrote. In all possible senses, how will the university provide the proper support that will allow us to thrive as students and contributing members of our university community? Concerning healthcare fees, Campus Reform notes that like almost every American college, Columbia requires its students to have health insurance or pay a fee to get insurance through the school. The undocumented students, however, are not happy they have to pay the fee. "We also demand full reimbursement of the health insurance fees," the group wrote, adding the school refunded portions of these fees, but the calculations are inaccurate and leaves graduating students with exorbitant amounts of account balances which potentially hinders their request for academic transcripts and degrees. The group also explained they want the university to protect them from federal immigration authorities. How can administration contact and keep in touch with undocumented students without a record of students that the administration may be in the future be forced to relinquish to federal authorities? They wrote. It must be noted that the list of demands comes as the majority of undocumented students attending Columbia likely already attend the school with their tuition and room and board being paid for. That's because, like other Ivy League schools, Columbia allows students whose families earn a relatively low-level income to attend for practically nothing. The undocumented student group was created last year around the time that Trump won November's presidential election. The list of demands may seem surprising, but in 2017, predominantly liberal and progressive students across the nation are feeling emboldened to demand concessions and changes from their administrations. A Columbia spokesman did not immediately return a request for comment from the Blaze. "I've just got to say, using 13 demands seems a little on the nose. Also, they have no rights." "Well, I take that back, they have the right to a cell they share with other illegals, to shower and pee in front of a room full of people and then a one-way, all-expense-paid ticket back to whatever godforsaken country spawned them. It's unbelievable that there are people, let alone illegals, who think that the world owes them food, housing, health care and education at someone else's expense. That's not even addressing their asking to be sheltered from the repercussions of the crimes that you've committed." This would probably still be something that would be noteworthy if these were just legal citizens who decided that their whims should be catered to by a university that is considered one of the most outstanding in the nation. However, when you add to the mix that these are people who have no legal right to live here, study here or even breathe the free air of the United States, It takes on a whole new level of crazy.